Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Jeppesen. I believe some of you have been before. I've been supporting this local entity for nearly 10 years now. Since 2010, I've been a promotion manager for MN in Copenhagen and responsible for the Greek market. My presentation right here, market overview with focus on GenSets. I have three topics. The mega trends that we need to navigate in, there's a lot of things happening in the market today. There's a second paragraph about market forecast. And the third one is the market in Greece. And I will touch on the survey that we did on the GenSets in October last year when we had the sustainable future seminar the Tuto seminar in November, or it was in October last year. So today, there's a lot of things happening in the world. We have a growing population, and many of the very young people there, of course, have a very strong touch on the online activities, and they also have a strong focus on environmental issues. And they demand, actually, legislation about all different kinds of issues. So this is, of course, something we need to listen to, and also something we're very interested in following. If we look on the left side here, robotics and artificial intelligence, this is something which is growing quickly. And also in our patrol systems, we are seeing strong development. From the beginning, we have had control of our main engines, integrating over time with the controls for the GenSets and also propellers and so forth. But more and more, we will be implementing interaction with online systems. It could be, for instance, if a fuel bunker report is notified somewhere by an oil company, and there's a specific drop in the price for a specific fuel, then maybe the vessel is online, and it will detect that now there's a fuel reduction on a specific fuel, and we're talking about a vessel which is capable of burning different fuels, some of the gases fuels, LNG or LPG or whatever, then it could be an interactive and intelligence system which is growing more and more. We also have the new biofuels, and we are talking also about green fuels which are based on nitrogen instead of on CO2. This is the very interesting development which we see happening. Zero waste energy. Rest in peace fossil fuels. This is something which will probably happen over the next 30 years. I believe you have all looked at the very ambitious targets from IMO on the reduction, the CO2 reductions. And if we are going to reach that level by 2050, then we need definitely to be able to operate vessels on different fuels than the fossil fuels. We have committed to a development of ammonia as a fuel which is nitrogen based, and this will take four and a half years. This is our development strategy. But there's a lot of other things, transparency, traceability, circular economy, like reuse and recycling of everything. And the herding behavior, the political consumer, is something that we need to listen to also, because people are becoming more and more aware of what is happening in the world with regards to emissions and so forth. There are changing trade routes, so we need to accommodate to whatever the market is doing. And we are also facing that there may be some technological quantum leaps which completely takes a different direction within the market. We don't know this yet, but these are some megatrends to navigate, and we definitely are trying to focus on this. You have probably noticed that our company name has changed since last year. It was MAND Turbo, but in the new environmental time here, I would say the name Diesel really doesn't sound very positive. So we have acknowledged that, and also we are seeing that the trend is that many companies have been based on product-based systems or product-based deliveries, which is now changing to more system-based deliveries and also focusing on a lot more service, and the market is actually demanding this. So our new slogan, Future in the Making, it includes focus, very much focus on systems and decarbonization, digitization, and so forth. So this is what we are addressing in the market right now and trying to look into the future. So now we are developing innovative integrated solutions. As you can see up here, very schematic. Main engine and auxiliary engines has been our major task previously. But in the past few years, we have merged into some other issues, propeller and shaft generators we have had for a number of years also from Alpha Legion. But we have the new hybrid solutions with battery and the combination with the PTOs and the GenSets. I will talk about this in my second presentation a little bit later. But also the fuel supply system will be accommodated to actually accommodate all different kinds of fuels in the future, so that you may be able to leverage your operation of whichever fuel is the most beneficial at a certain point. Going towards the market forecast, this slide shows the stable fundamentals in the world. This is the gross domestic product for a number of different countries. As you can see, India is actually leading in the world on the gross domestic product, with a growth of almost 8% per year. China and US, Europe and Japan are mixed there also, but as an average of the world, we are seeing a gross domestic product of an increase of almost 4% per year. And as we know, the global trade is actually following the gross domestic product in the world, and that means we will see for certain, we're quite sure we will see an increase in our market, in the marine market. And as you can see from this graph, 78% of all goods transported are actually based on seaborne transportation. And the columns here are indicating with the different colors the different types of vessels that are the most common ones. As you can see, the lower blue ones, this is dry bulk, the red ones is deep bulk, and this includes crude oil, but also LNG or methanol or liquids. And then we have the container, the light blue. This one is a little bit surprising, maybe, that it is not more, but this is because the container ships are shipping a lot of different goods in the containers, and the weight of this is actually not that that much. When you look at the bulk carriers and the tankers, they have a very dense cargo. I mean, they're bulk, and this is measured in tons cargo. So this is why the light blue is a little bit lower. And then finally, the cost ones are the land-based cargo. So you can see this is a very steady business we have, and we are estimating that the increase will be approximately 33% within the next 10 years. So there has been crisis, but we are also seeing that things are maybe stabilizing. These four graphs here are showing the cost index 380, say just over this is heavy fuel. We have the taxi index, this is the freight rate. We have the new building price index, and then finally we have the financing cost of new buildings. And as you can see from 1990 until approximately the crisis that came in 2007 and 2008, these numbers and these indexes have been quite stable. Then we have seen a strong irregularity at the finance crisis, and we saw a strong increase of the fuel, as you can see the blue curve here. But then all of a sudden in 2014, the fuel prices came down tremendously. But they're coming up again. But now we are seeing all the legislation, and we are just in front of the 2020 SOX regulation. We have tier 3, and we have a lot of things on the agenda. But things are stabilizing, but we will probably suffer a little bit from overcapacity from the heavy years of 2003 to 2006 to 2007. Another thing, a tendency we are seeing today is that the costs have been decoupled from the earnings and the competitiveness amongst the suppliers is great, very strong. We are actually experiencing that first cost is the major driver right now above the operation cost. So cost and efficiency are the key to progress. And here is a graph which is showing the order status. We have seen that the legislation will definitely impact the pace of the recovery. Probably slower than expected earlier, but we're seeing the 0.5 soft cap coming right around the corner, 2020. We're seeing the tier 3 legislation coming in the Baltics and Europe in 2021. And we're also seeing the phase 3 of the EEI level, which is impacting the efficiency and the design of the business. And then in the very top, we have the CO2 regulation, which is further out in time. So will the auxiliary market also change? And this indication here, this graph shows that the medium speed auxiliary power, which we're talking about today, we are optimizing it. It will be a stable business still, and it will definitely be the dominant business. But we are seeing with the dark blue, this is a high speed auxiliary power. This may increased a little bit, but the gray one, which is the hybrid auxiliary power, will definitely grow, and it may be even more than what we see here. We have some challenges, of course, we have that in our business, but when we're talking about the four-stroke gensets, we are seeing that alternative energy sources on commercial business may be reducing the market on the gensets. Hybrid power pack. This is something that is happening right now. I'm talking about it a little bit later in my second presentation. But this actually generalizes the number of gensets that are installed on each vessel. Instead of having three or four gensets, maybe in the future, it would be common to have maybe only two or three because of the battery load sharing and TO and so forth. There's a lot of other different challenges. Spare parts and service competition from competitors, also from hybrids, we see that. We have some of the companies that we have licensing agreements with, they also have their own designed gensets. And that may be also a future challenge, especially in China, I would say, because the China state has a lot of money. Fuel prices and alternative fuels, if we want to be able to follow everything here, then we should make our gensets fuel flexible also. We have done it already for the LNG, for the two engines, 2028. But maybe we will also introduce LPG on the gensets. And of course, the biggest issue, the prices of the gensets. This is something that is playing a big role, whether we are in the market or not. And then we are also, as I said, focusing on system solutions, and we are actually gaining some very nice package orders. And this is an example of a package order that we just received recently. This is our 4-stroke 5160 Poison engine or, from Augsburg. We have sold this to a ferry, and we have actually achieved to sell also the dual fuel system, the supply system, by our new entity, Piraeus, in Sweden. We have also had AKA, which is the Canadian specialist within hybrid solutions and expert power management and so forth. They have designed this the control system. And we have the special propeller system and gear system. Unfortunately, we lost the genset order for this. And the reason was that we were just on the verge of getting the approval for the dual fuel gensets for the small boat, for the whole boat. But we didn't have it right there. So we lost that order, unfortunately. So one thing that we as learned from this is, of course, that we need to have everything in hand, we need to have everything ready, and we also need to have it shown, and it has to be visible on the market. I'm just showing this slide here, which is showing the orders of different vessels in Greece the last 10 years or so. As you can see, the green, the majority of the vessels earlier were the green columns. These are bulk carriers. A lot of green owners are or have been the majority bulk carriers. But that has changed a little bit, as you can see. On the latest orders from 18, we are seeing that tankers, VLCCs, and also LPG and LNG vessels have become dominant in the market. Of course, this is because of the business potential. When we're looking at the licensee order book for our gensets, we have seen over the past decade or so that the majority of the production of gensets was the red one in was earlier in Korea. The yellow has been the majority in Korea, but we, as you have seen, the red has been becoming more and more dominant. This is the Chinese production of our gensets. But if we look at the general order book, we can see that over the last decade, the order book has diminished. It doesn't really say something about the market share, and it doesn't really say anything about the orders in relation to business and so forth. So we can only see that the our order book is coming down, and we have discussed this in-house in the company, and we have also seen a tendency that our gensets have lost some grounds and some market share here in Greece. So when we had the technical seminar last year in October, the sustainable future, we conducted this survey on gensets, where we actually succeeded to get 53 respondents completed on the survey successfully by the crowd that were here. It was conducted by means of an electronic survey that could be downloaded on telephones. There were 24 questions. The first 10 was company and personal data. The question 11 to 15 was about personal opinions and preferences. And 16 to 24 was about company priorities. And I think one of the reasons that we got so many respondents was because we could, there was a chance to bring 2 free seats in our diesel academy, which were probably a good thing to do. The results have been very positive for us. We have is that the Greek market is really strong, strongly requesting reliability and availability, high quality. Also, in the question of will your company order gensets of our brand for your future new buildings, the answer has been perhaps depending a little bit on the promotion. We need to be more visible, and also it depends on the benefits. We try to accommodate that, but also depending on the prices. And in many cases, for new buildings, many shipowners are considering gensets as a commodity, as a commodity. And during new building projects, the decision about gensets is taken very late. And we would like to come in earlier in the process when the shipowners are asking us to come and discuss different issues on the main team. We would also like to discuss the gensets because we are focusing on the package solutions, and we would like to also include that and propellers and different other equipment. So we have developed or upgraded the specific Mark III version of 2330, and we decided to make a genset campaign here in this country. And we decided to schedule it for June, so we are having this genset campaign now. And we're saying L2330 Mark III, one size fits almost all. And the next speaker, Paul, will come into the different features and design details.